The new CEO of 103-year-old Panasonic has some very new views on how to run the company. The new Panasonic CEO wants to make more batteries for Tesla, invest billions in shakeup. River Davis and Yuki Furukawa report in Bloomberg that the new chief executive will spend 2 years sharpening operations, and the strategy seeks to enable large-scale M&A boost battery output. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla electric vehicle and electric vehicle battery news, and give us thumbs up, please, if you find this report informative. So Bloomberg reports that Panasonic's new president and chief executive officer, Yuki Kusumi, is embarking on a new two-year mission: churn out more batteries for Tesla vehicles, and shake free billions of dollars to invest in new areas of growth by making the company more efficient. What's interesting here for us is what Panasonic wants to do for Tesla and for other electric vehicle companies. So Bloomberg says he won't be doing that from the second floor office used by the company's founder, a room for overlooking a fountain and manicured lawn dotted with statues at Panasonic's Osaka headquarters. The 56-year-old who rose through the engineering ranks is shunning the space to work alongside staff, just like Elon Musk from Tesla. Kusumi, who formally takes the helm of the 103-year-old Japanese company Panasonic on Thursday, says he is focused on improving efficiencies from the manufacturing floor up. That type of work can't be done locked away in the president's office, he said in an interview earlier this month. Those are the types of things I'm out to change. Some 20 years ago, Panasonic was topping global consumer electronics sales with a hand in everything from televisions to digital cameras and mobile phones. In the years since, it's faced tightening margins and rising competition from rivals in South Korea and China. What's now critical to Panasonic's future growth is its relationship with the world's biggest maker of electric vehicles and ability to claim a share of the global market for electric vehicle batteries that's projected to reach $35.4 billion in the 2023. Panasonic's change of guard follows a decade of unparalleled shifts for the company, which operated for most of its time as Matsushita Electric Industrial, before changing its name. Kazuhiro Tsuga, Panasonic's previous chief executive, spent close to 9 years shedding struggling business such as plasma TVs and ultimately handed to Kusumi a linear company no longer bleeding red ink. Now it's Kusumi's job to steer Panasonic onto a path of growth, and looks like Panasonic is looking into Tesla for kind of steering that path of growth and other electric vehicles, because like I said, the battery market is going to be huge, $35.4 billion in 2023. Better efficiency in operations, such as manufacturing, will increase Panasonic's ability to generate cash, in turn freeing up hundreds of billions of yen to direct toward the new initiatives, including mergers and acquisitions. I don't think it'll take 2 years, but we're pushing to reach that state, Kusumi said. Many of the struggles that Panasonic encountered supplying batteries to Tesla in the past stemmed from insufficient productivity. According to the new CEO, the high-flying automaker's oldest battery supplier in 2014 committed to invest in the multi-billion dollar battery factory the two joint operate in Nevada. The years since have been contentious at points, with Panasonic facing frequent and in time public prods from Tesla CEO Elon Musk to boost battery production. And I've reported that at TorqueNews.com. Many of you who are following Tesla and Panasonic at our channel, you probably already know about that. But then things turned into better. The automotive business, which made up about a fifth of Panasonic's 6.7 trillion yen, $61 billion in revenue for the fiscal year through March, faced a long stretch of operating losses before turning profitable. Kusumi remembers working under intense pressure from customers. Kusumi says, it doesn't matter how much you want to grow sales or increase profit if you don't have the capacity to do so, he said. Going forward, the company will focus on raising plant operation rates as much as possible while automating processes and keeping facility costs low. With our new structure, we're going to polish this ability, and if you stay tuned, we'll invest again in building supply capacity, Kusumi said. Panasonic is working to set up a prototype production line to test 4680 batteries, Tesla's 4680 batteries, a next-generation lithium-ion cells, touted as the key to unlocking cheaper and more ubiquitous electric vehicles. If Panasonic looks to be capable of churning out better performing cells more efficiently than rivals, it will make a large investment in their production, according to Kusumi. Panasonic will seek to supply them off to Tesla as well as other automakers. Kusumi's focus on efficiency has roots both inside out of the Panasonic. The new CEO said he was particularly influenced by Toyota Motor Corporation in the years leading up to the launch of a joint battery venture with the automaker last year. Toyota's manufacturing concepts, known as the Toyota Production System or TPS, focus on perpetually improving efficiency and have been widely emulated by others in auto industry. There are few companies in which operational strength is itself a strategy, Kusumi said. The efficiency of Toyota's sites ties in closely to its profitability and cash generation, and in that regard, I saw we're not doing everything that we should, he said. The drive to streamline site operations is one of the reasons Panasonic's leadership decided to spend more than $7 billion to acquire artificial intelligence software developer Blue Yonder earlier this year. With the Arizona-based company's software and its own sensor technologies, Panasonic can analyze site operations for inefficiencies such as when workers are being left idle between tasks, according to Kusumi. These kind of digital solutions accelerate the speed at which we can eliminate bottlenecks from site one by one, Kusumi said. The idea is to utilize Blue Yonder software widely within Panasonic's business division and wrap it together with internal technologies to offer as a solution to customers. Kusumi also often alludes to the management philosophies of Konosuke Matsushita, the founder of the business he now helms. In the 1930s, Matsushita famously expanded the company's share of the market for radios by cutting production costs by half. Now is the time to again spread this idea within all of our business operations, Kusumi said. So friends, let me know, what do you think? What is the future for Panasonic, and what role do you think Tesla plays in the future of Panasonic, helping Panasonic to build the 4680 batteries as soon as possible to put them in Tesla vehicles and have better range and more mileage on our electric vehicles. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Have a great day, friends. Please subscribe to our channel, like this video if it was informative, and I'll see you soon in our next report. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section below. God bless you. Peace be with all of you.